the plants which are on the earth. In the previous class, we have studied we are on the planet Earth. In Earth, so many things you can see. That is, tree, plants, grass, climbers, right? Water. You can see so many things in the earth. In that, plant is also one of the living things. Okay? When it comes to the chapter, plant on earth, in the beginning, there is a picture given for you as an activity where you have to color it. Okay? See, there is a plant. And now, I'm going to draw the picture of the plant. Okay. I'll write it here. See, this is the plant. have to color it yellow. See, there are five major parts in the map. One is the root. Okay, this is the root. And this is the stem. This is leaves. This is the fruit. And last, this one is the flower. Okay, so these are roots. Okay, for roots you have to color it brown, because the soil or the mud, it will be most of the time brown and brown. So the roots always will be in brown color. And next, the stem. The stem you have to color it in gray. And next, the leaves. You know, leaves is always in the green color. So you have to color it green for all the leaves. And the fruit, you have to color it red. And flowers, you have to color it yellow. So you have, that is my activity. You have to color it. And next, let's go for the chapter. So, what do you know about plants? See, plants are living things, but they cannot move. From the time of living until it dies, it will be in a one place, but it can breathe, it can reproduce. Okay, so plant has many parts. So now let's learn about their parts, and today we are going to know about plants, and there are eight kinds of plants. We will learn kinds of plants and what are plants are. Okay, so for the first, plants are living things. We see various plants all around the earth. Plants make our earth beautiful and colorful. Some plants we see are very big, like gulmohar, mango, neem, etc. Some plants like rose, jasmine, etc. are smaller than trees. Some plants are very small and they usually grow for one season. All cereals, grass, peas, etc. are such plants. So, the seasonal, they only grow. Okay, so yes, plants are living things. Okay, and there are various plants, so many types of plants you can see. And plants are on our earth, it will make our earth beautiful and colorful, right? There are so many flowers. It is very beautiful. It's sometimes some flower smells really very good, right? Just like that, some plants are, as I told, it's very big trees, and plants are small. Okay, so now let's learn more about different kinds of plants. And the first, herbs. Okay, so some are herbs. See, maize, coriander, mustard and wheat plants. All these plants. And there is one more quality of herbs, that is, the herbs is also used to prepare medicine and we will use it in our cooking. Okay, we will eat it. We can eat the herbs. We can cook it and we can eat it. That is one more quality of the herbs. So, these are called herbs. Okay, so next is creepers.
Shrubs have many branches close to the ground. Shrubs are of many kinds.
soft, thin. Green cells, it will be small, but shrubs will grow little bigger. It will grow little bigger than the herbs. Okay? And they have a thick stem. Even if you want to break it, it's little tough. Okay, if you want to pluck it out, it's really, it's very thick stems with deep roots. See, these are the roots. It will go little more deeper to the ground. This roots will be inside the ground, that is, it will be inside the earth. Okay? So, these types of plants are called shrubs. What are the shrubs will be having? The roots will be deep. Be bigger than herbs. So these are the three points where shrubs are defined. And the examples are rose, hibiscus and cotton plants are the examples of shrubs. I guess you will be seeing rose plant, hibiscus plant, those are all flowers. Right? And cotton plant, all these are the examples of shrubs. And next is trees. You have seen so many trees when coming to the school, or if you are going somewhere outside, you can see big trees. You can see coconut trees near your house, right? So let's see about trees. Tall and thick plants are called trees. It will be, the trees will be very tall. Will be very thick. They have a deep root system. Their stems are thick and strong. They have many branches which bear leaves, flowers and fruits. Right, okay? You know, trees are very tall. It is more taller than the plants. Plants, almost plants will come to this height. Will be very big. It will be having so many branches. It will spread out so big. Okay? They have a deep root because it is very huge, no? It is very broad. It will grow, it will spread. But the root system what it will be having, it will be very big. It will spread so many places inside the ground. Okay? The stems are thick and strong. The stem for tree, it will be a bark. It's called a bark. The brown color. Okay? That is called a bark. It will be thick and strong because it has to hold the branches. It has to hold the leaves. It has to hold the fruits. So, the water. Okay? So, desert plants no road, okay, no house. It is only sand. Everywhere you see only sand. Okay, so in that area, what are the plants will grow is called desert plants, and there is no more plants will grow. There are some category, I guess 3 to 4 plants will grow. That in one example, they have given cactus. Cactus is an example of desert plant. So cactus is an example which will grow in desert. So 7th one is aquatic.
Trees.
Okay? So you can see trees. Tree stem is
you can see lotus. See, even though if it is floating on the water, the roots are under the water. It's inside. The roots are inside the water. And the last one is hilly plants. Okay, hilly plants. See, you can see the needle like leaves. It's sharp in the edges. So these are the kinds of plants. And all green plants are known as producers because they have prepared their own food. They do need water and food. They can live anywhere, though they are living things. Yet they are unable to move from one place to another. Once a plant begins to grow somewhere, it remains there as long as it lives. They need air and sunlight to grow.
Germination of the plants. Okay, thank you.